hip-hop's etymological origin. A word's etymology is how it was formed and when. Words are important, you should be informed of them. Here's an etymological lexical chronicle, wrought to give thought and full to its topical vocable. Hip-hop, a genre of audible optical thought and flow. Get taught, it's part of hip-hop to know, you know? And so here it is, the etymology of hip-hop. Well, hip comes first, but at first hip was hep, which meant up to date, with it, and in step, which in 1914 first appears with that name in the now rare Vocabulary of Criminal Slang, which claims that it came from a detective's last name who was, legend has it, always hep to the game, and so his name became a saying, he's hep, like he's heard of it. But some say that's wrong. Here are other alternatives. Some say that it comes from ancient plowmen and shepherds who, when herding, would shout the word hep to their herds. Hep, hep, like tut tut, the kind of word you're using as you do in hip-hop when you're getting things moving. More likely so. Sources, on the other hand, say that it's from the Wolof language of Senegal, Mauritania, and Gambia. Hepi, to open one's eyes. Well, that's eye-opening, and should come as no surprise, since West Africa was the home of the griot, or jelly, who practiced the ancient art of tale and poem telling and preserving a cultural knowledge by rapping it. But some say even that etymology isn't accurate. But wherever it came from, what matters is where it went. It entered the vernacular of black Americans in the 30s and 40s in what they call the Jive Era, 50 years before Jive and era, and its usage continued in the context of jazz, first among musicians and then among the fans. So a hep cat went from being a jazz man to later being a white intellectual jazz appreciator. And ultimately, as hip made the transition from hep. If that was a transition that you weren't hip to yet, and you still said hep and not hip, well, then you'd fall into the category of persons who were not hip at all. Hop, as in jump, or a one-footed leap, first appeared in the 1500s from a deep proto-Germanic root word in modern form hoofen, to engage in a bouncing, springing forth movement, combining then hip, which means conscious and aware, and hop, which means making a leap in the air. You have conscious movement, that's how Karras explains it. He's the teacher of hip-hop, I teach ancient languages. DJ's a disc jockey, it's an established acronym. Less obvious, perhaps, the MCs that rap to them can stand for the master of ceremonies or for mic checker or the less-known microphone controller. Graffiti's Latin via Greek and via Latin from Italian, and even ancient Romans wrote but not on iron stallions. Breaking is from brecken, Old English to shatter. Old English 800 is a good way to get plastered. Rap is onomatopoetic, and so whoever did invent it when they thought it and said it made up a word that recreated some impression that came before, like the rapping Edgar heard it as chamber door. It came from ancient Danish, here becoming a term of art. It meant a light quick blow. It also meant fart. And that's poetic justice, cause it's obvious there are some rappers who claim to drop shit that's just air. That's rap, but what about trap? In the past 10 years, everybody's feeling that. But where'd the word come from or where's the word at? It was slang for the spot where you drug transact. Trap, deriving from trap, that inner onto which someone can step, implying a movement that comes to a stop. And some people don't like it, some like it a lot. Why not? I'm not really saying either way, I'm trying to say the way it went and whence it came and since it came to get its name and then became a way, a statement that's pervasive in the game. And oftentimes it's like a homophone, it kinda sounds the same. I guess it's half the title, but it's everywhere late. I guess they call it trap, cause it's hard to escape. Hip-hop evolves and undergoes changes, and yet somehow its essence transcends and stays changeless. And the line between who's real and who appropriates it is whether you make it in such a way that no haters can say shit. That's what I'm trying to do. And I recognize genre is nothing more than a means to catalog an author. And I don't care if what you call what I do is hip-hop or historical essays masquerading as song words. What I care about is this: regardless of your origin, when a crowd hears your voice, be sure you inform them, make them hip to what's real, make them hop to what moves them, make them think, make them feel, give them thought, give them movement. For this is the function of language and music, however you may make it, wherever you may do it, cause words are just words and what's real is just facts. And it's not just where they're from, it's where they're at.